Hi, it's Keir Findlay Bates here, and today I thought I would talk about the difference between a Bitcoin node and a Bitcoin miner. So, starting with the nodes, the Bitcoin nodes together create a peer-to-peer network. When you fire up a node, you need to have the address of at least one other Bitcoin node that is participating on the network, and that node will then give you the addresses of other nodes that it knows, and in this manner, Bitcoin nodes create a network. And what they do on that network is they transmit information that they receive to the other nodes. And that information may be transactions that users hope will be included in a block on the blockchain, or the information may be newly discovered blocks. And furthermore, a Bitcoin node will also send earlier blocks to other nodes so that they can build up the underlying database of all the blocks that the Bitcoin network has currently created. So nodes are all about communication. They're all about sharing information across the Bitcoin network. Now, a miner is something different. A miner gathers that data and builds candidate blocks to be added to the blockchain over time. And a miner might be part and parcel of a node. You may take a node and bolt a miner onto it, or a miner can be a separate entity, but it will still need to gather the information off the network, and it may use a node as a proxy. In fact, even if the miner is in the same machine as a node, they're still two separate components of a system. And a miner does not need to make itself public to the entire Bitcoin network. It can just connect to one node to gather the information that it needs. And then ultimately, when it thinks that it's found a next candidate block for the blockchain, it can transmit that block to a node, which will then broadcast it across the entire network on the miner's behalf. So the Bitcoin client originally did actually have a miner built into it. So it was both a wallet and a node and a miner. However, over time, those different components have been pulled out, and you can now get wallets that are not themselves nodes. You can get nodes that do nothing other than do nodey stuff. And you can get miners that don't have a node or a wallet built into them. And this makes sense. Whenever you have multiple functionalities, it's usually more efficient to have different components or even different software packages performing those jobs. So hopefully that's explained to you the difference between a Bitcoin node and a Bitcoin miner. And we even threw in a bit about wallets on top of it. I hope you found it interesting, and I'll see you all in the next video soon. Bye for now.